Can you see, this is a typical external staircase, okay, which is used as a fire protection, okay, including high-rise building. Can you see here, okay? Can you see this one? An external staircase is desirable to be provided for high-rise building. Very important, it should be provided for high-rise building. Shall be kept in sound operable condition. Cleaning, maintenance should be continuously done. Shall be directly connected to the ground. So means from here you should go to the ground level. Entrance shall be separate and remote from the internal staircase. So this and that internal staircase should not be get easily connected. Okay, their entrance should be separate. No wall opening or window opens on to or close to the external staircase. See here, so window opening is separated from this passage. Okay, that should be maintained, window openings. Route to this external staircase shall be free from obstruction. What do you mean by that one? Wherever from an entrance lobby, when you are entering it to this external staircase, it should be free. It should be free from any obstacle, furnitures. Okay. See here, it should have a straight flight. Means what? From here to here, one flight. Okay. Straight flight. From here to here, one flight. Okay. Shall not be less than 1.25. Means what? This width. This tread width, or what is that, wide, okay, 1.25 meter, 250 mm tread, risers 190. So the number of risers shall be minimum 15, okay, sorry, maximum 15. So in one flight, one go, maximum 15 steps are allowed, okay. After that you should give one landing, again it should come back like this, okay. Handrails shall be provided of a height not less than 1 meter. Means what? This is already purely made by concrete, so that is why handrail and everything is embedded here only, okay. So minimum height from this to this, 1 meter, minimum height 1 meter, and not exceeding 1.2, not exceeding 1.2. provision of balusters with maximum gap 150 mm. If something like that 150 mm gap balusters are there, then a little bit so the maximum gap of that baluster spacing should be 150 mm. Okay, spiral staircase. This is one typical spiral case. The use of spiral staircase shall not be less than 1500 mm in diameter. Means this diameter should be minimum 1.5 meter. Okay, it should be big. Shall be designed to give adequate headroom. Means what? The person when he is walking, no, his head should be free from other obstructions. Okay. Unprotected steel frame will not be accepted as a means of escape. Only if you are protected, only if you are providing steel frame without any balustrade, without any handrail, then it is not accepted as an escape route. Okay. However, steel staircase in an enclosed fire rated compartment of 2 hours will be accepted. That means what? If it is withstanding at least 2 hours of fire resistance, then it is accepted as a it's a escape route. Okay, so now we have seen no horizontal exit in the previous one. Okay, if you go there, yes, here it is there. This is called as horizontal exit from one building to another building. So in that way it is explained here. Fire, no fire, means from here to here that persons are moving. So the width of horizontal exit shall be same as that for exit door face. From this door they are opening, no? So that width and this fire exit width both should be same. So this horizontal exit shall be equipped with at least one fire smoke door of minimum 1 hour fire resistance or self-closing time. So this door should be automatically, so its fire resistance capacity should be 1 hour and it should be self-closing. Where there is a difference in level between connected areas for horizontal exits, ramps not more than 1 in 10 slopes shall be provided and steps should not be provided. Means what? This building is at another level and this floor level is at another level. So you cannot provide steps here. You should provide a sloping ramp and that slope should be less than 1:10. Less than 1:10. It should not be more than 1:10 slope. So ramp means what? There are no steps. Okay. Those type of things should be provided. Doors in horizontal exits shall be operable at all the times from both sides. Means doors shall be operated from both sides. Okay, now refugee area. Can you see this building? There are no refugee area. There are no balconies provided here. People are there only inside. This is called as area of refugee. Wherever some balcony is there, no, some people will come and sit there to get saved by fireman, fire police. Okay. So that shall be provided on the periphery of the floor. Means what? Here on the periphery, outside of the building, not inside of the building. Okay. It is a cantilever projection, nothing but a balcony. It's nothing but a balcony. It's already told you that for every 24th floor, one refugee area. For next 39th floor, one refugee area. And next plus 15, plus 15, plus 15, like that is if you add, no? So for every 15th from 39th floor, you should get one refugee area. That is the meaning. If balconies are there for every floor, no problem. That acts as a refugee area. Fire towers. These are preferred and safest type of escape route for storied building, fire towers. Okay. In high-rise building with over 8 stories or 24 meter in height, at least one required means of egress shall be preferably be a fire tower. Means that is a single separate tower. From there people can pass. Okay, that is there. Shall be constructed of walls with 2-hour fire resistance, with 2-hour fire resistance, without openings other than exit doorway. So only exit doorway shall be provided. Can you see this diagram? It's a World Trade Center accident. So it caught fire. So a lot of people have lost their life due to this accident. Okay. What is happening? It's a high-rise building. So it's a very, very high-rise building. What precautions we have taken? They say high-rise buildings are constructed to be fireproof. Most of what is inside the building including furniture, okay, furnishings, belongings, can burns, everything, they will produce lot of heat and smoke. Okay, furniture, dust, sofa, okay, everything will produce lot of heat and dust smoke when they get fire. So that is the main problem. People will die because of suffocation. Okay, that is the main problem. Okay. Now, this is typical fire protection 15 meter and above buildings. Okay. Here, how should the construction be done? All materials of construction in load bearing elements, in stairways, in corridors, in facades shall be non-combustible. Very important. All materials should be non-combustible. The interior finishes should not have a flame spreadability rating exceeding class 1. These are the classes. You understand this one. Whatever finishing you are providing, no, maybe paint, maybe whatever, this one you are providing, finishing touch. So they should have less flame spreadability. The internal walls or staircase shall be of brick or RCC with minimum 2-hour fire rating resistance. Okay, so whatever walls you are providing, no, or staircase you are providing, no, so their fire rating should be minimum 2 hours. After 2 hours only they will start falling or collapsing. The staircase shall be well ventilated. Yes, the roof of the shaft shall be 1 meter above the surrounding roof with fire resistance rating of 2 hours. So shaft roof should be more than other roofs. What about lift? These are the typical lift photos. Can you see? Walls of the lift enclosure shall have fire rating 2 hours. Okay. So whatever the walls are providing now inside, the minimum rating should be 2-hour fire resistance provided with the vent. Provided with the vent at the top. Okay. Top of the lift. Landing doors in lift enclosures shall have fire resistance not less than 1 hour. So these doors should be at least 1 hour fire resistance. Means within 1 hour this should not get damaged or this should not get fall or collapse. The number of lift in a row shall not exceed 4. Means continuously four lifts should not be provided. Collapsible gates for lift shall not be permitted. Collapsible means these are automatically opening and closing. Collapsible means hand driven. Okay, those may get jammed for that. Lift shall not normally communicate with the basement. Means what? They should not go and take place it at the basement level.